So yeah, today I'm going to talk about running this ES 2015 on Node.js and Babel. So for those of you who are new to JavaScript, ES 2015 used to be called ES 6, and it's a new version of the JavaScript that's just finalized this year. That's why it's called ES 2015. And currently, the main way to run it is most people, they run ES 2015 by transpiling it from this compiler called Babel.js. And one recently, Babel, it was just upgraded from version 5 to version 6. And I heard there's quite a lot of people have many problems using the new version of Babel. So that's how I decided to use. So who still stuck at Babel version 5? One. Or who haven't tried Babel before? Yeah. So the first thing is that actually the latest version of the Node.js, if you look at it, which is Node version 5, is already supported quite a lot of the ES6 features. So what happened? Okay. Yeah. So the recently there's quite a lot of development going on with Node.js, and the latest version is version 5.2. And if you check the website, the number of ES6 features that's available is already quite a lot that's available. So for example, the most basic one are like, for example, block scoping and arrow functions. So I just give an example here. So I have a folder here. So I have an example project folder. And here, these are all the example functions that can be run without any assistance. So you just need to install the latest version of Node. Then you can run it. So for example, here I can say Node. SRC node native and arrow. So you say like two square of 2 is 4. So you don't need any transpilation. Same for like, for example, classes, right? Those of you don't need to write like prototype anymore. So you can like just write in this syntax, and the Node.js version 5, it will auto support it. So there are many other features like formal generators and symbols, but I will leave you to check it out on this repository that I just created. And then for the rest of the features, there are just a little more features that not supported by Node, and that's where you need this Babel, which is version 6. And the main difference for Babel version 6 is that it have a lot of different packages. So for example, if you want to install the build tools, you have to install this Babel CLI instead of Babel alone. So this CLI, it will install the command line, the Babel command itself, but it does not do anything about the actual transpilation. So if you want to say like, I want to transpile specifically this ES 2015 features, you have to install a preset like this Babel preset ES 2015. Or there are also another thing which I'll cover later, which is the Babel plugin. And then for compilation, my approach is usually that to have a source folder, which is the SRC folder, and then transpile it, output it to the out to a directory which I call out. So your SRC contain your original source code, and your out contain your transpile. And the reason for this is also mainly that it's faster. And also, it's easier to debug because, like, if there's any exception, the Node.js it will output your stack trace in the transpile, the line number of the transpile code. So that's, and then this command like Babel and then out directory out, and then SRC is the folder, so it will transpile all your SRC folder. But if you run just this command alone in the new version of Babel, which is version 6, it does nothing, and the default thing you need is to add a preset. So you have, for example, you have to say like, I want to use the 2015 presets. to transpile all my code. Then it will automatically transpile all the ES 2015 features to the existing ES 5 code. And then this is usually the default way to do it for if you want to target browser, web browser, because like maybe your browser, not all browsers support ES 2015 yet. And then you can, and then if you look at the Bubble website, there are many other presets, which is like from both stage zero, which is like, actually is the features in ES 7, which is the next version of ES 6, which is also ES 2016. And stage zero is like the newest features being developed, and they are not stable yet. And for example, stage three is the most stable features that are going to come in the next version, which is ES 2016, or some people call it ES 7. And then you can also set like multiple presets. So for example, let's say you want to use React together with ES 2015, you can say like, I use both these presets separated by a comma and also without space. So, and then also for Bubble version 6, there's this new version, new concept called plugin, which is that a preset is collection of plugins, and then your plugin is just individual features. Like for example, you have the async function plugin to enable the async function. And then you can mix like the async and other presets together. So the other thing I want to talk about is the custom preset. So because currently Node.js, it has many of these features already are available natively. So for example, if your code is you only want to run it on Node.js and the latest version of Node.js, then you probably don't need to transpile everything to ES5. Because it is usually better to use the native version. And then in this case, you can do what is called a custom preset. And then you can even like publish it as a NPM package, and other people can use your custom preset. So for example, here I have a preset, node preset. Oops, I think I... So here it goes. So a preset is basically very simple, like you just export a list containing things like the plugins, and then all these individual plugins, like for example, destructuring is not yet available in Node.js, the latest Node.js, and also things like for example the next generation, like the async function. So, like for example, let's say this is the destructuring, and this is the async function. And then what I can do is that I can just copy. So I will just do this bubble presets, and then instead of doing like ES 2015, I set a path, relative path, or you can give the full name of your package if you are using an external one. So if you run this, you just compile everything and put the out directory, which is here. And if you see here, then you see like here, this is my transpile version of the async function. And this is the transpile version of the destructuring. So here you can see like, and if you look at from both the native code, like from both the arrow function, you can see like arrow function is not transpiled. So you continue use the original feature. So do class. Yep. So an alternative way for doing this is you can have a bubble RC file. So an example bubble RC file is like this. So you can say I want to use the preset ES 2015 and plus some like new feature that's coming in the next version, like from the async function and function bind. And yeah, that's mostly all. And there's some quirks for this new version of Bubble. In my opinion, the new version is much more robust. Like you can customize it much easier, and it could be much more predictable because you can know exactly how Bubble will transpile your code. But this also means like you have much more package dependencies, and it's not that straightforward to figure out how to run it in the beginning. And also like just before this, when I was preparing this presentation, I figured that it could be like very very painful if you misspell your command line option. So So like from there, if you say bubble preset instead of presets, so what this thing do is that it actually doesn't transpile anything. So like you get back your original version because you treat it as the same like the bubble without any preset. So the default command is that it just pass everything and it doesn't transpile. And then I actually spent like almost an hour seeing like it was working and then just as I wanted to present, it doesn't work. Yeah. So that's all.
I got questions.
Thanks.
Got warning one or not?
No warning. Yeah. And somehow like I use like the async function and then it say like invalid syntax. Then I was like, I already included that plugin. Then why is this still error? Yeah.
Ouch.
Yeah. So yeah, that's all. Any question? Or we can move on. Next one. Yongjin.
Okay. When we presented our SVG, but instead